The initial reaction that we had from the federal government's decision was disappointment.
That's one way to describe how Milton and Regional Council are feeling after the federal government has approved the CN Rail Intermodal Logistics Hub. Milton Regional Councillor Mike Lewitt says they were really hoping the decision would go their way.
We were hoping that through the panel that was struck 2 years ago and the hours and hours of testimony brought forward by Milton residents and other partners through that process was going to be heard. The CEAA panel advised that there were going to be some significant adverse environmental effects and that CN would have to address that. So when it went to the federal government, we were hoping that, you know, that decision could be reversed or the approval not given.
On side with Milton and regional councils is Milton MP Adam Vancouverden, who says this is actually a conditional approval.
I would hesitate to call it an approval because the 325 conditions put on this project by the Minister of the Environment are quite restrictive and could potentially mean that this project is cost prohibitive for CN going forward. So one of the very important restrictions and conditions put on this project is that they can never exceed 800 trucks in a 24-hour period. 800 certainly sounds like a lot, but they operate 24 hours a day. Still, too many trucks in my view. But if they run 805 trucks per day, 5 days in a row, that's a $40 million fine. Because as soon as they exceed a certain number, it becomes an $8 million fine. That's just one of the 325 conditions put on this project.
On a provincial level, MPP Parm Gill has been working on this file for the past 2 years. He says these 325 conditions should not have been conditions, but rather reasons to reject this proposal.
I mean, come on, explain me. What is the need for approving that project, especially when the community has been fighting this project for over a decade? You know, I obviously committed on my part as a provincial representative in the last election, should I be elected, that I will fight against this project. And immediately after getting elected, the provincial government actually became a party in support of the court challenge that was launched against CN by the region, by the four municipalities here in the region of Halton and Conservation Halton. So, you know, honestly, I am very, very disappointed.
So if this is a conditional approval, what can happen next? Councillor Clewitt says they are going to get to work to convince the feds to reverse their decision.
Obviously, Halton Region has a number of options, you know, appealing a decision or other legal avenues that we can take going forward. And that will be happening in a very short amount of time from our Halton Region legal team. And I call it the Halton Coalition, the four area municipalities, the Halton Region itself and Conservation Halton. Still has some options available. And we're urging the Milton residents and Halton residents to continue to express their disappointment in this decision by emailing the Environment Minister as well, just to let them know that that decision was not what this community wants.
For up-to-date and accurate details on the CN Rail Hub proposal, go to the Region of Halton's website, halton.ca. Reporting for Halton News, I'm Alyssa Candelaria.